What if a defense system could spot a fighter jet before the pilot even saw the radar warning? What if it could track 80 targets at once and destroy a ballistic missile flying faster than sound? This isn't science fiction. This is Russia's S-400, one of the most powerful air defense systems on Earth. Welcome to Top Thought, where we uncover the world's most fascinating technologies through stories that matter. After the Cold War, Russia realized that the skies had changed. The enemy would no longer knock on the door with tanks. It'd strike from above. Fast, silent, deadly. So in the late 1990s, Russian engineers began working on something extraordinary. A defense system that could not just see into the sky, but control it. That's how the S-400 Triumf was born. By 2007, it was operational, and ever since, it has been reshaping global defense strategies. Imagine this: an enemy stealth aircraft is flying at Mach 2, thinking it's invisible. The S-400 sees it from 600 kilometers away. Within moments, it calculates trajectory, speed, altitude, and locks on. One button, and the hunter becomes the hunted. Key features of S-400: detection range, up to 600 kilometers. Engagement range, up to 400 kilometers. Target speed, up to Mach 14, over 17,000 kilometers per hour. Altitude coverage, from as low as 5 meters to 30 kilometers. Multi-targeting, tracks and engages up to 80 targets at once. Missile types, 4 types for short to long range threats. It doesn't just shoot, it thinks. It uses phased array radars and command posts to form a real-time 3D image of the sky. The S-400 isn't limited to jets. It can take down stealth aircraft like the F-35, cruise missiles, ballistic missiles, drones, AWACS, and even hypersonic targets. And it's deadly even before launch. Just its presence deters enemy aircraft from entering airspace. Russia has deployed the S-400 across its major military bases and in conflict zones like Syria. But it's not just Russia anymore. Countries that bought S-400: China, to counter US and Indian air power. India, despite US pressure, bought 5 units. Turkey, a NATO member that faced US sanctions. Belarus, Algeria, interested or in delivery process. This system is not just a weapon, it's a geopolitical chess piece. Each S-400 regiment costs nearly $500 million to $1 billion. But for that price, you don't just get a few missiles. You get mobile launchers, radar stations, command vehicles, support and maintenance units. Each unit is mobile, can be set up in under 5 minutes, and can operate in extreme climates, from Siberia to deserts.
Which can be either a BAS tractor truck or a MAS series transporter erector launcher vehicle. The latter can accommodate up to 4 launch tubes housing a variety of missiles. There are 4 missiles of different ranges and calibers, including a short-range missile of 40 kilometers, a medium-range missile of 120 kilometers, a long-range missile of 250 kilometers, and a very long-range missile of 400 kilometers. The S-400 missile system comprises 3 types of radar systems. The first one is the Big Bird. The 91N6E Big Bird acquisition and battle management radar is mounted on an 8x8 trailer. It has a range of 600 kilometers and can detect and track aircraft, rotorcraft, cruise missiles, guided missiles, drones, and ballistic rockets. It is capable of simultaneously tracking up to 300 targets, making it one of the most advanced mobile radars. The second radar system is the Fire Control and Target Tracking Radar, known as Gravestone. It is a multifunctional radar with a range of 400 kilometers and can detect targets at all altitudes. The third radar system is the 40V6MR, which is used to detect low-flying targets that employ terrain masking to hide from radar. Some sources argue that the 40V6 is not a radar, but an optional tower that can be detached from the chassis and mounted on the tower using a crane. The Ural truck serves as the mobile command and control post for the S-400 system. It is from this post that all operations from target detection to missile firing are managed. The basic step-by-step process of how the system works is as follows. The Big Bird long-range surveillance radar detects and tracks targets, with the capability to track up to 300 targets simultaneously. The information is then relayed to the command and control station, which determines whether a target is friendly or hostile. The station may also receive orders from higher command authorities. Once permission to engage is granted, the command and control center orders the launchers to launch the appropriate missiles based on the range and type of targets. The engagement radar guides the missiles to their targets. The engagement radar and surveillance radar constantly interact to determine the missile trajectory based on the real-time location of the target. In the case of low-flying targets, the mobile mass system serves as the last line of defense. It can track cruise missiles and other unmanned aerial vehicles and launch mid-range.
Western analysts call it a no-fly zone machine. When S-400s are deployed, even top-tier fighter jets hesitate. US F-35 pilots are trained to evade it, not confront it. Its long-range detection and ability to hit multiple targets make it a nightmare for any invading force. Even NATO acknowledges a battlefield with S-400 changes the entire strategy. So the next time you look at a clear blue sky, remember, there might be an S-400 watching, silent, ready, invisible. Thanks for watching Top Thought. If you enjoyed this deep dive into global defense tech, like, share, and subscribe for more thrilling insights into the systems shaping our world. And always remember, in modern warfare, the one who controls the sky controls the future.